Now let's start refining our simple ERD into a full ERD. And I'm going to zoom out a little bit here so I can see the whole thing. And then I'm going to squish this down. And I've opened another smooth draw window here. So the first step in refining this is that these binary relationships, relationships between two entities, they don't need any additional work right now. But there are also ternary relationships, like works for and enrollment, that are relationships between three or more entities. So that's what a ternary relationship is. And these have to be resolved because you can only really represent binary relationships in a database table. You can't really represent ternary relationships, so you have to resolve them first by creating something called an intersection entity. And an intersection entity is basically just an entity that you create to resolve either ternary relationships or, we'll see later, end-to-end relationships. So let's start with this first one. So works for instructor, semester, department. I'm going to create a new intersection entity here called assignment. So an instructor is assigned to work in a department in a particular semester. So each assignment record entity is going to have exactly one instructor, exactly one semester, and exactly one department. But then an instructor can have multiple assignments. There can be multiple assignments for a given semester, and a department can also have multiple assignments. So let's go ahead and draw what that would look like. So I have instructor. And I have assignment. And an instructor can have more than one assignment. Each assignment has exactly one instructor. And then department, I spelled that wrong before for some reason, department can have many assignments, but each assignment has exactly one department. Get rid of that. And finally, semester so there can be multiple assignments for a particular semester, but each assignment has exactly one semester listed. So an assignment record will be like Mark Goodman is assigned by the CIS department for winter of 2016. So that's the first intersection entity. And then we don't need to resolve this part of between department and SAC. So I'm just going to go ahead and actually let me change the size of this here. So department to SAC, a department belongs to exactly one SAC, and each SAC might have multiple departments. So the way this works is, for example, the CS department, there's a CS department at Rock Creek and a CS department at Sylvania, but they're both part of the CS SAC. So each department belongs to one SAC, but a SAC can have multiple departments. And then SAC administers course. That doesn't require any special work just yet. And I'm going to come back to this for a second. I'm going to jump up to this enrollment relationship. So this is a relationship between three or more entities, so it needs to have an intersection entity as well. Let's get started with that. So what I'm going to do to resolve this particular one is I'm going to create a section entity. So a student actually enrolls in a section, and then the section is a section of a particular course, like CIS 275, and then this section is CIS 275 that you're currently taking. And then a section has a date and time, and a classroom, and then the section has an instructor and a semester. So instead of having a ternary relationship, now I have an intersection entity for section. Now let's start working through the cardinalities here. So a student can sign up for multiple sections, one section for each course the student takes. But then a section can also have multiple students in it. So there's 25 or so students signed up for CIS 275. And then each section has exactly one date and time. I'm assuming that date and time is like Monday and Wednesday at 6 to 9:20 or whatever. And then there can be multiple sections at a particular date and time. Each section has one classroom. There can be multiple sections taught in a classroom at different dates and times. A course can have multiple sections. There's probably three or four sections of 275 this term. Each section is exactly one course. And then a section is taught in a particular semester. A semester can have multiple sections. And a section can be taught by an individual instructor. An instructor can teach multiple sections. So while I was doing these relationships, I actually made some assumptions here that may not actually be correct. So for example, can you have a section that meets in different locations? If so, then one section could have multiple classrooms. How about a section that meets at different dates and times? Is that possible? How about a section that's cross-listed between multiple courses? So for example, you might have a course section that's a political science course that's also an economics course. So same section, but cross-listed with two different courses. If so, then section is going to have multiple courses. How about a section that's taught by multiple instructors? This is actually pretty common in the CS department, so I think I'm going to go ahead and change this. To many instructors. So all of these assumptions that could go either way, these are the kinds of things that you're going to want to ask the customer about. So there's a question on the lab about your assumptions for the ERD. These are the kinds of things you're going to want to list there. So a SAC can teach many courses or administer many courses, And each course is administered by one SAC. So once again, this is an assumption that you may want to check with the customer. Can you have a course that's administered by more than one SAC? So at this point, I've resolved all of the ternary relationships, but I have some end-to-end relationships. And let me go ahead and zoom out a little bit here. Let's make sure I got everything. Yeah, it looks like I have everything. So in addition to creating intersection entities to resolve these ternary relationships, you're also going to have to create intersection entities to resolve these M to N relationships. So once again, each section has exactly one date and time. Each date and time can have multiple sections. So this is a 1 to N relationship. And those are perfectly fine for the database. Basically, you have a primary key here in date and time, and a foreign key here in section. So the section references a particular date and time. However, if you have an M to N relationship, it doesn't really work because you end up with multiple values in your foreign key field. If you put the foreign key here, and you put the primary key here, then you end up with multiple foreign key values for a particular record, which is not legal. It breaks the definition of a relation. So in order to resolve these M to M relationships, we need to add another entity. And I'm going to go ahead and box select this thing right here and cut and then paste and drag it up here so I have a little more room. And then I'm going to create a new intersection entity. So a student enrolled in a section . But this time it's going to be an intersection entity. And then get rid of this part here, get rid of that, and then clean it up a little bit. So an enrollment record is a record of exactly one student being enrolled in exactly one section. And then a section can have multiple enrollments, and a student can have multiple enrollments. So a student can enroll in many courses, a course can have many students enrolled in it. So an enrollment has one section, an enrollment has one student, but then a student can have many enrollments, and a section can have many enrollments. And that's how we resolve an M to N relationship by creating an intersection entity. So now I'm going to do the same thing. An instructor can teach multiple sections, and a section can be taught by multiple instructors. So this relationship cannot actually be represented in a table. So to fix that, I'm going to go ahead and erase. And actually, let me go ahead and erase this too. So I'm going to create a new intersection entity here called Teach Assignment. Like so. And then a teach assignment record is a record of exactly one instructor being assigned to teach exactly one section. And then a section can have multiple teach assignments. So if there are two instructors for 234A, then the section of 234A will have two teach assignments. And then an instructor can be a participant in multiple teach assignment records. So I can be assigned to teach multiple courses, but each teach assignment has exactly one instructor. So now I've resolved the M-to-N relationship between instructor and section into two 1-to-N relationships between instructor and teach assignment and teach assignment and section. So that seems to be all of the N-to-M relationships, as well as all of the ternary relationships. So now let's do the minimum cardinalities. So we already stated for enrollment and for these other intersection entities that this was going to be a record of exactly one student enrolled in exactly one section. So the minimum cardinality here and here are both one. And same thing with this teach assignment. And same thing with the instructor and semester, department, and then section. All has exactly one of these. So those are all by definition when I created the intersection entities. And then for the rest of these, let's see. Can you have an instructor who isn't assigned to teach any classes? I'm going to say yes, so that would be zero. And then can you have a section that doesn't have anybody assigned to teach it? Well, that's a better question. I think this is the kind of thing you might want to ask the customer about, so it's certainly an assumption, but I'm going to assume that you create a section before you've assigned a teacher, so you may actually have zero there. Can you have a section that nobody is enrolled in? Certainly at the beginning you would. Can you have a date and time in which no sections are assigned? Yes. Nobody teaches a course at midnight. Can you have classrooms that have no sections assigned to them? Yes. Can you have a course that has no sections, if it's a brand new course? Can you have a SAC that doesn't have any courses? I'm going to say no here. I'm going to say that each SAC has to have at least one course, or else there's no purpose or reason for the SAC to exist. Can you have a course that isn't assigned to any SAC? No. The way it works at PCC is that each course is developed by the SAC, so the SAC has to exist before the course can. Can you have a SAC that has no departments? I'm going to say no there as well, but that's an assumption. Can you have a department that doesn't belong to a SAC? Not at PCC. Administratively, you always have a SAC if you have a department. Can you have a department that have no instructors assigned to it? I'm going to say yeah. If it's a brand new SAC, you might have a dean, but you might not have any instructors assigned yet. Can you have an instructor who's never been assigned to a department? Actually, I think the answer to this one is no, because the instructor gets hired by the department. And if there's no department, then the instructor can't be an instructor. So I'm going to say one here. Can you have an assignment without, can you have a semester in which there are no teaching assignments? I'm going to go ahead and guess on that one, but this is the kind of thing you'd want to ask the customer about as well. And I think that's all of the minimum cardinalities. So now I've specified both minimum and maximum cardinalities. I've resolved all the intersection entities, and I've resolved all of the N to M relationships. So that's going to be my answer for question 2.